let us say we have two bodies which are initially at rest, but I want to make them rotate with some angular velocity about this axis of rotation. So first I will look at this body and I will apply some efforts to this body, or I will spend some energy on this body such that now it has started to rotate with some angular velocity omega. Okay, I will come to this body. Now I will apply some efforts to this body. I will spend some energy on this body. I will see that I have applied such an efforts, or I have spent such an energy such that this body is also rotating with the same angular velocity omega as this body. But I find that I had to spend more energy to this body than this body. It means that this body has more rotational inertia, also called as moment of inertia, as compared to this body. Okay? Okay. Since I have spent more energy over here than here, the kinetic energy of rotation that is associated with this body should be greater than this body. So kinetic energy of this body, the first body, should be lesser than the rotational kinetic energy of the other body. Correct? So once again, why is kinetic energy more? Because I have spent more energy on him. Why I have to spend more energy on him? Because his rotational kinetic energy, rotational inertia is more, or the moment of inertia is more. Okay? Okay. Now, our next job is to find out the formula for rotational kinetic energy. So if I plug in the formula for rotational kinetic energy over here and here, I can exactly see what exactly is more over here than over here. That exact term will be moment of inertia. Correct? So first we have to derive the formula for rotational kinetic energy, that we'll do just now, and then we'll come back to this situation. So let us say this is a body which is rotating about an axis passing perpendicular to the board through this point, and suppose the body is rotating in this sense with some angular velocity omega. As the body is rotating, each and every particle of the body, of course except the ones which are on the axis of rotation, except those, all the particles will be moving in circular motion. Okay, like this. Correct. So m1, m2, .. mn are the masses of the particles of which the body is made up of, and these particles are at r1, r2, rn, these are the perpendicular distances from the axis of rotation. As the body is rotating, the particles will have linear velocities, let us say v1, v2, and ...vn. Okay? The rotational kinetic energy of the entire body is nothing but the summation of the translation kinetic energy of all the particles. So it will be half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square plus ... plus half mn vn square. Okay? Now what is v? V is nothing but r omega. So what will be v1? V1 will be equal to r1 omega, correct. V2 will be equal to r2 omega. ...vn will be equal to rn omega. Each and every particle will be rotating with the same angular velocity omega as that of the entire body, but their linear speeds will be different depending on the distance from the axis of rotation. So instead of v squares, we are going to substitute r square omega square. Okay? So r square omega square. So over here, omega square will be common and 1 by 2 will be common. So what will be left with? 1 by 2 in bracket, I will have m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus ... plus mn, mn rn square. and omega square, that was common. I have taken even that out of the bracket. So the rotational kinetic energy of any body can be written as 1 by 2 summation of mi ri square, where I will vary from 1 to n, omega square. This is the rotational kinetic energy of any body. Okay, so now we have derived the formula for rotational kinetic energy. Now what was that? It was 1 by 2 summation of mi ri square omega square, where I will vary from 1 to n. For this body is lesser than 1 by 2 summation of mi ri square omega square, where I will vary from 1 to n for this body. Now if you compare 1 by 2 omega square, 1 by 2 omega square is same. So what exactly is less in this body that determines the moment of inertia is this quantity. What exactly is more in this body that again determines the moment of inertia is this quantity. So do you understand that summation of mi ri square is nothing but moment of inertia of any body? Okay, so the moment of inertia for any body about some axis of rotation will be nothing but summation of mi ri square, where I will vary from first particle to the last particle of the body.